tunnel my vision. You young and she get like me. I got your shorty, she with me. I gave her a jersey. I told her to join my team. It's best you go and save. You know how I play. I get you a safe like Frank. You can teach money to fly. I turn it and hop. I catch it and go to the bank. It's crazy. I'm used to the lights. I'm shining so bright. I'm buying her to come my face. You see me working and working. I'm getting it. I'm as soon as you feel me.
Nah,
I told my boss, it ain't no limit. Told
all the dogs, it ain't no limit.
Put your head in the game, head in the game, head in the game. Head in the game, head in the game.
They screaming my name when I walk in the building. Yellow diamonds on me like I pay for the stealers. I'm in the club just like a stealer. Oh, this your girl, poppin' at the stealer. I'm on the beat and I float like a
rapper.
Yeah, right across the middle. He's speaking next to me, tell me riddles. Can't stick with the gang, so we have to sit up with him. I'm in LA, right around and around. My dog just called, say you finna touch down. When I call, I'm taking a real sound. Hold on, money calling right now. I gotta go and get it, and it don't matter how. All I know is that I'm taking touchdown. I keep my head high and my eyes on the prize. My feet on the
ground. Damn, you done ate the whole bag?
What's up right here?
Damn.
First open in 2002. There's a look inside Ford Field here in downtown Detroit, the Motor City. Tonight, it's the Thursday opener for the new NFL season.
I bet you tell me
that. The Vikings and the Detroit Lions.
I know.
We'll follow around the corner. Football is back, America. And we're underway on EA Sports. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. Second and nine now. That's caught by the big tight end, T.J. Hockenson. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. It's a gain of 16, and the Vikings have the first down as well. There you go, Charles, the first completed pass of his young career.
And we expect it not to be his last. Very good to get the first one out of the way, though, as he begins his career.
Perfectly fine.
First down, here's the run with Cook. And he'll be taken down just shy of midfield. It's a 6-yard pickup, and it gets him to second and four.
Now, Brandon, that's the way you want to run the football. There should almost be cold bubbles above the offense right now. Bam, boom, biff. That's how they feel good about moving the football.
The last run got six, now second and four. The play action fake, they'll look to throw. He is left with no option here but to throw it away.
I think he had to hold that one before he wanted to. He was right up in his grill. I think he was a dentist there without a license, don't you?
Just not enough time for the play to develop. Just lucky it wasn't a fumble, really. Now they face a third down and four after that incompletion on second down. Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. And that is incomplete. Oh, he had a defender right there with him to force that to the ground. And fourth down now coming up.
That's exactly what defense is talking about. You've got to find ways to get off the field when you can, especially on third down. And third down defense going to be vital in this game. Able to knock that one away and force a fourth down.
Lions going to stop us momentarily as they call a timeout. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. Let's go now. They'll try and throw for it here. We're looking for Jefferson, but this is intercepted. Picked by Tracy Walker. Chips by him at the 25.
Well, short of them returning it for a pick six, that was about the worst start you could ask for in this one, because your advantage of getting the ball first is gone, and they're set up a short distance from your end zone. Now you're counting on your defense to prevent a touchdown, and your offense, you better be ready to come out swinging on the next series.
Hold it ready.
And he'll get about five here, so he'll take this down inside the 20-yard line.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent game.
After the pickup of five, here's second and five. And they'll keep leaning on the running game, back to the ground. And stopped a few yards shy of the goal line at the three. That one goes for 16 yards and sets them up first and goal. A chance for their first points of the season here as it's first and goal. They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And he's going to take it in for a Lion touchdown. A 3-yard touchdown run. And the Lions are on the board here first in the season opener. And now, of course, all scoring plays are reviewed, and I think they're going to take an extra long look at this one. Another shot from the one on second and goal. Now they'll switch it up here and look to throw. And he just chucked that one out of bounds, out of everyone's reach. Maybe a wise call not to take a sack in this part of the field. It brings up third down.
This is where good coaching and execution come into play, because down this close, you absolutely don't want to turn it over. Good job keeping that in mind as he escaped, bought time, and decided to...
And he takes this one in for a Lions touchdown. Punching it in from a yard away. And the Lions take the early turnover and convert it into an opening touchdown. Point after, right down the middle. And that makes the score 7-0. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. Here are the Vikings now to start their next drive. They threw an interception the first time they had the football, wound up leading to a touchdown the other way. How do you approach drive number two?
Going back to your game plan coming in, everyone...
Oh, you saw that one coming. It's intercepted, thrown back across his body. Picked by Tracy Walker, and the Lions are going to take possession of the football. They'll come out throwing here on first down. Going right side here, and that's complete. And he's brought down inside the 20 at the 18-yard line. Here's second and a yard. They'll try and run this one right up the gun. And he'll get into the end zone. Touchdown, Detroit. A great effort there. Already his second touchdown here in this opening weekend. And the Lions are able to strike quickly to add on to their lead. Extra point splits the uprights, and it's now 14-0. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. And here comes a return from the middle of the end zone. And in hindsight, probably should have taken a knee as he only gets this out to the 16-yard line. Here are the Vikings now to start their next drive. And for this offense, Charles, you got to think kind of crucial here to put something together on this drive, because remember last time out, they threw the interception on the very first play.
And you can't afford to let this defense keep building any more momentum. They're playing awfully well, and they're awfully confident right now. To me, it's time to attack and take some of that momentum back. But make sure you're selective in doing so. Understand where you want to throw the football, and make sure it's open before the ball leaves your hands.
Looking for more there on first down, but this throw downfield, incomplete.
We know he has a lot of confidence in his arm and likes to force it downfield, but the coverage was tight there. Fortunate it wasn't picked off.
An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. Cook up the gut. Now he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. Backed up here. Tough spot. Needing 11 yards to pick up the first. Off the play fake. He'll look to throw. And here's another interception, the third of this first quarter. And the Lions are going to take possession as they've got it at the 42-yard line. Certainly not what he was hoping for, Charles. That's now three interceptions in this ballgame.
But there's a lot of knowledge to be gleaned every time you throw an interception if you do things the right way. And hasn't there been a pretty darn good quarterback along the way who threw a lot of interceptions early, learned from them, became great later? Who would that be? That'd be Peyton Manning through 28 his rookie year. That's the NFL record. How'd things turn out for him?
I think, okay, he's a guy in all the commercials now, right?
Yeah, I think he's doing okay.
They go play action here on first down. Got a man, it's caught inside the 10. Touchdown, Detroit. Foster Moreau, 40 yards. And the Lions are looking good here in the season opener as they're able to extend their lead. Extra point right down the middle. And it's now 21-0. So how about this for a start? 21-0 here in the first as they kick this one away. And from deep in the end zone, he's going to bring this out. And he's probably realizing he should have stayed in the end zone as he can only muster a return to the 14-yard line.
For most people, the excitement of a kickoff return is to see a long one that goes back in the opposite direction. But for the guys covering it, it's being able to stop them deep in their own territory. How about that incredible form tackle right there? Shoulder in the ball carrier, and down he goes.
He'll get 4 yards of the carry there, and we will get to the end of the first quarter of play. 21-0, our score. The pickup of 4. Here's 2nd and 6. Here's a play fake as they set up to throw. And he wisely will throw that one away.
I tell you, Brandon, this defense is playing with some confidence. Haven't allowed a point yet. Flying to the football. I'm telling you, it's almost 11 to the back on every snap. Another nice job there to force an incompletion.
On 3rd down, he'll drop to throw. And he will not be able to hang on through the contact. It's incomplete. The coverage strong, and now it's 4th down. So on 4th down, on is the punter, Ryan Wright. And taken right on the 30. A very nice punt that time, but they get 11 back on the return. And the Lions will take over. The Detroit offense ready to begin their drive. And Charles, nothing like squaring off with a division opponent, a division rival in week 1. Do you like that they are matching up this early, or would you prefer a game like this be a few weeks down the road?
I actually like the early matchup for a few reasons, Brandon. First of all, it allows you to see that the entire offseason and know, hey, right out of the gate, we're playing a division game. Second part is it spreads them out a little bit. If you just have them all bunched up at the end of the year, that's not as much fun watching teams try to survive that gauntlet when you do have injuries down the stretch. And last but not least, let's face it, we're TV people. What a great game to sell right out of the gate.
Now a throw to the end zone on first down, but it winds up incomplete.
Early on, the running game's been working well, and the offensive line has been pleased by that. The thought process there, catch those safeties creeping up, trying to help against the running game. They tried to hit them over the top, unsuccessfully.
On play action, they'll throw. Complete. This is Mitch. And now look at this. Big gain, but a fumble. And this is going to kick out of bounds. Boy, a fortunate bounce or two there. They'll keep possession back inside the 10-yard line. Now a chance to make that big play really hurt. It's first and goal just outside the five. Here's a give up the middle. Down at the two. Broke through first contact, but ultimately stopped shy of the goal line. 5 yards, a good run there, and now second and goal.
Pass the 50, pass the 50.
He'll look to throw. Looking end zone, but it's incomplete.
That was a touchdown if he could have hung on. Instead, it was a well-timed collision to jar that one free.
A chance to really put this game out of reach. Here's third and goal. They'll try to run this one in. And this one will wind up with him losing yardage back to the 4-yard line. And a loss of 3 to bring up 4. Well, speed is definitely a calling card if you play cornerback in this league. And he does a terrific job there of hustling in quickly to make the play. So taking a risk here early in the new year, they're going to go for it. They'll try and run for it. And he takes this one in for a Lions touchdown. A great play there. On his way to a monster game. 3 first half touchdowns. And the Lions are able to widen their lead here in this first half. And his kick is good and flags fly as well. Some frustration showing through right now. This is going to be a roughing call. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. And he'll just take a seat, and the drive will begin at the 25-yard line. Here's Cook as they begin on the ground. And this will be a gain of 5 as he gets it to the 30.
They'd love to just strike back with a touchdown right here. And if it's a long play, so be it. But the main goal, get a couple of touchdowns, run some plays, run some clock, allow their defense to get a chance to catch their breath, settle down, and relax a little bit after they just gave up the score.
He has enough for the first down on the keeper, a gain of 6. They'll set up a throw. Going for the deep ball. Got a man, it's caught inside the 10. We saw this plenty last year in college. He loved to take his shots downfield, and that throw, that was a thing to behold there. And they'll try the option on first and goal. And he's able to get it down to the 2-yard line. Give him 4 yards there on the first down keeper.
Well, if you're going to run the read option, typically, you've got to keep an eye on the defensive end.
And what does that mean? What are you looking for with a defensive end?
Well, you want to play off of what he does. If he collapses inside towards the running back, then you pull it and take it yourself outside in. If he stays outside, you go ahead and leave it with the running back. In this case, pulled it and got good yardage himself.
On second and goal, Cook waiting in the backfield all alone. Now here's a little touch pass as they tap it quickly to their receiver. And they will stop him after a fairly minimal pickup. Another shot to at least get on the board here. This is third and goal. They'll run for it with Cook. He's not going to get there. That won't even be close. It was blown up in the backfield. They just do get. Well, that'll be caught. It's St. Brown of the half. Point after, right down the middle. And the round is on here in this first half. Here are the Lions now as they line up and kick this one away. And he won't return this one. He'll go down to a knee, and they'll start at the 25. Here are the Vikings now to start their next drive.
Things for them, just to put it bluntly, man, it has been tough sledding here in the first half, facing that big deficit. The clock is dwindling now. Maybe if they can get something on the board here before intermission, they'll have at least a little momentum heading into the second half.
On first down, he'll drop to throw. And a big loss here as he's taken down. So we have reached halftime here in the Thursday night opener as we'll head down to Orlando. That's where we find our man Jonathan Coachman in our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach.
I know Kelly, you're trying to sleep.
Welcome back. Charles and I settled into the booth ready for quarter number three. Boswell on now to kick this one away. This will be brought out from the middle of the end zone. And in hindsight, probably should have taken a knee as he only gets this out to the 16-yard line. The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive.
They got to be thrilled with how they've operated so far in this one. They've got the nice lead and now a chance to score here on three straight possessions.
Yeah, and the way that they are rolling, I just don't know how they get slowed down, because they certainly are operating at peak efficiency right now. They might want to think about getting some of their backups a little bit of work, though. Let some other guys get on the field and do their thing and save some of this for the next time out.
Not his best throw there, but we sit right now in the third quarter. He's had a pretty good game throwing the football.
He certainly has, and it's not exactly at the point where we're doing four-minute offense yet, but they've got to think about, I'm not going to say milking the clock, but understanding clock management on out.
And now the third down throw incomplete as well.
That's an excellent job right there on third down. Like any defense, you never want to let them get anything started. And that would have been a first down. Instead, you saw the contact on time, no penalty. And before this drive could get wings, it's fourth down.
They're indeed going for it as they look to throw. And able to complete it to Moreau. And he is going to have the Lions first down as the defense nowhere to be found there. A gain of 20 on fourth down. They'll look to throw here. And that's caught inside the 35. And he is brought down, but not before reaching the 30. A very nice pickup of 33 yards.
Altogether, a pretty shaky start to the year for this defense as they defend another first and 10.
Now, here's a look for the end zone, but that one's going to wind up incomplete.
I like the thought process there. They connected on a big play, and sometimes you find the defense vulnerable. So they went for the bigger shot, went for it all on that one. This time, they were ready for it.
So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. Back to throw again. And that falls to the ground incomplete. A nice job of bodying him up defensively. And now it brings up third down. This offense was on the move. Now two straight incompletions have him looking at third and 10. They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw. And the throw there going to be incomplete.
And those two just haven't been in sync thus far. They've done a nice job against him, but still, with his talent, you would expect them to have more completions to him in this game.
They'll drop to throw.
It's Rodgers here with a grab. And he is going to have the Lions first down as this defense cannot come up with a play that they need. In fact, they surrender a big chunk, 17 yards there on fourth down. From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. And that is caught. Touchdown, Detroit. Armani Rodgers from 13 yards out. And the Lions take the opening kickoff of the third quarter and drive right down the field to extend their lead. Extra point splits the uprights, and it is 42-0. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. This is going to be returned from middle of the end zone.
In this position, trying to get back into the game, teams are looking for a spark from their special teams. That's not what they got, though. They got a setback, and they have a long field to cover if they want to try to put points on the board.
Here are the Vikings now to start their next drive. Trying to fire up that running game with Dalvin Cook. A nice run there, 9 yards, and it'll be second down.
Well, it's time for them to be good teammates right here. What I mean by that is possess the ball for a little while. Get at least 2 first downs. Give their defense a chance to settle down a little bit after they give up a touchdown.
The previous run, good for 9. Here's second and a yard. Again, it's Cook. And down he'll go at the 25. They'll get 3 as the drive continues. It's a first down.
Second and 1, and people want to run the football. This is where every back in the league is supposed to do exactly what we just saw there. Pick up the first down.
Oh, they're going to run a little pop pass here. And he is going to lose yardage here. Ball at the 24 and a second and 11. He'll look to throw. This is caught. It's Boyd. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. A gain of 28 yards there and give him a first down. A 10th carry in the game for Cook. And good space to operate there as he takes this down inside the 35-yard line. Still in search of their first touchdown of the game, but they're on the move. First and 10. Now this one to his tight end out on the right side. No gain on the play. And that will bring up second down. Another completion there. And we think back to the draft. This franchise essentially handing him the keys to the operation. A top 5 pick. Charles, how ready do you think he is?
I think he's ready for the NFL in terms of size, speed, the makeup of him, the character of him. The key's going to be, will this team accept everything he brings to the game and adapt to it? Not just necessarily plug him into something that he doesn't do well.
Here comes the 8th play of the drive, and they need a full 10 yards on third down. From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. And my goodness, another interception. And he will bring it back. An interception return for a Lions touchdown. Point after here coming up. And the lead grows even larger here in the third quarter. So they throw the pick 6. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. Here comes a return from the middle of the end zone. And he'll be brought down shy of the 20, so the decision to bring it out of the end zone, not a good one. Here are the Vikings now to start their next drive.
Well, we're still in the third quarter, so there's some time to kind of clean this up and make it look more respectable now. A win, that's probably gone out the window, Charles, but I don't know. Do you look at this as a time to just improve and maybe start to look towards the future?
I think you have to find something to play for, something to grasp onto until the clock runs out. But Brandon, we've been around this game a long time. This is an outlier. You don't get many blowouts like this no matter how the game looks on paper going in. This one has turned out to be everyone's worst nightmare realized.
Back now at Ford Field. And this is a blowout so far as we get set for the fourth quarter. A very one-sided affair. Second down, they go right back to Cook. Well, this will be a short gain of three before he's brought down at the 22. The Vikings on third down. A pretty woeful 0-for-5 thus far. This will be third and six. Now we've got movement up front. And I think this is going to be on Minnesota. Ooh, moving from his tight end spot there.
Do you think that perhaps the play call was for him?
So the false start certainly doesn't help matters as they'll try again now. Third and long. They're going to look to throw. He's got his man, T.J. Hockenson. And a pretty nice tackle there, ranging up from his free safety spot as he'll stop him about a yard short. That's a gain of 11. Would have been a first down if not for that penalty moments ago. Running for it. Here's Cook. And they're going to stop him on fourth and one as he'll end up going backwards. Dalvin Cook turned away on fourth down. And the Lions will get the football back in terrific field position.
Let's go now. 1800.
They'll come out throwing here on first down. Jamison Williams, 26 yards. And the Lions are closing in on a winning start to the year as they extend their fourth quarter lead. Extra point right down the middle. And this one was over a while ago as they just add on to that big lead. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. This will be returned for and all deep in his own territory. He coughs up the football. And they are going to take possession of the football inside the 15 at the 14-yard line.
And in our meeting with the special teams coordinator, we asked him, what's your philosophy on bringing the ball out? Do you give them a red light? Do you keep them in? Green light, let them go? Let's see if he changes from green light to red light after that costly error.
Yeah, you know what I remember from that meeting? He brought donuts.
I like him.
Yeah, it was great.
Yeah.
But he's not happy right now.
No, don't tell everyone how many I have.
Here's a first and 10 at the 14-yard line. They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. And in for the Lions touchdown. Foster Moreau, already his second touchdown here in this opening weekend. And the Lions continue to pour it on here in the fourth. Point after, right down the middle. And this one was over a while ago as they just add on to that big lead. The kickoff unit is out on the field and they will send this one away. He will return this from deep in the end zone. And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23. A very costly holding penalty. It backs him up all the way inside their 10 to start this drive. Now Cook, he's got it off the draw. And he'll get what he can up the middle, 3 yards. And that'll bring up second down.
You know that old expression, it's not my night? It hasn't been his so far. I don't know if the legs are a little bit heavy. Sometimes having to hang out all day and play doesn't exactly play to your advantage, but it's been a tough go for him.
And every time he looks up, somebody's there defensively. That was the same case on that play. Second down, it's Cook again. And he'll be about a full yard shy of the 20 at the 19-yard line. Following the good run by Cook, Here's another first and 10. They run with Cook. He's been busy tonight. And he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair. 2 yards the loss, second and 12. And the offense knew it. They were already starting to walk back as that one is accepted. And that false start penalty certainly not helping their cause here. Second down and long. Now they'll switch it up here and look to throw.
They're going for Jefferson downfield.
And that's going to be incomplete. Good effort there, trying to take a shot, but it's third down.
They'll probably spend a little extra time dissecting the game film after this one. I think part of their plan was to hit them over the top of the deep ball. They've been unsuccessful all night.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. He'll drop to throw. Nowhere to go here. He lost the football. And it looks like the offense did get the football back. That end zone, and it's going to be a safety. Things are just going from bad to worse now. It's a safety that does him in here, and that is one frustrated offensive unit.
They can't get out from under their own shadow right now. I mean, I know this is the NFL, but could you imagine a college crowd right now? Imagine what they'd be doing. They'd be chanting, start the bus, because they think this one is over.
The Detroit offense ready to begin their drive. Been a very strong performance for them, really, on both sides of the football. The turnover on downs, the most recent example. And now, obviously, he's got a man complete. And he'll have it past midfield, almost to the 40 before being taken down. That one nearly 30 yards, 29 officially. From Viking territory now, they'll come up first and 10 at the 41. They'll look to throw. That's complete to Moreau, the tight end. And they are able to stop him, but he does take it all the way to the 2. 39 yards there, a big one. Looking to throw. Under pressure now, and he's going to go down. Sacked back around the 8. It's second and goal, back to the 8-yard line now. Now it looks like he'll throw here. And this will be caught. And the carnage continues. It's another touchdown. Good throw there. Too out of proportion, but he looks a lot more comfortable in his second season.
You can tell he put the work in the offseason, and what I mean by that is understanding the playbook, not just the plays and how to execute them, but how to do it against a variety of defenses. Also understands his team better, what they can and cannot do. You can see the confidence rising in him as he plays.
This will be brought out from the middle of the end zone.
In this position, trying to get back into the game, teams are looking for a spark from their special teams. That's not what they got, though. They got a setback, and they have a long field to cover if they want to try and put points on the board.
Here are the Vikings now to start their next drive. And they knew coming in that this would be a tough place to go in and win a season opener. But this has just been a performance, to be frank, not to be proud of, as they trail big in this fourth quarter.
Yeah, he doesn't want to shake your hand though, right?
Someone moved. Flag is out. That's going to be 5 yards.
And that'll drive coaches crazy. You work all week on dealing with loud crowds, on dealing with motion, and then you have a guy jump.
And that full start penalty certainly not helping their cause here. Second down and long. They run it again with Cook. And he'll take this forward only up to about the 7. Third down now. Those last two plays indicative of how things have gone for them. Just nowhere to go on the ground and struggling to put up points. Third down. Here's a run by Cook. And he's going to be taken down here at about the 10. As expected, they're going for it to keep the drive alive. And now here is another interception. Picked off by Bryce Callahan. And the Lions come up with a late turnover. But it will probably only matter to the statisticians as this ball game is now officially over. For the winning team here, Charles, and that's about as big and clean of a win.
I'm supposed to make
a check.
I'm gonna go get a little thing of soap.